What is good, friends? We're here with OUPL, Psychic Mutu. I don't know how to pronounce his opponent, but it's like the first time he's playing in OUPL. I think he's a monotype player, is what I've heard today, but I'm not sure if that's true. It's like the monotype tier leader or something like that? Or the monotype, like someone known in the monotype community. Yeah, they bring the same team, so I assume. Yeah, I was not sure for a second if it's the exact 6 months or if one is different, but it's exact 6 months. So they either stole it, have the same team builder, or like someone passed it to them. I think League used the team like this. Actually, it's not the same team. He has a Landorus over Garchomp, so yeah. Restart, please. Don't want to watch this AIDS. I'm so he leads with Greninja. I assume this is Fistdive, Mew, AV, Magnezone. For both teams, I assume that it's AV Magnezone to check Greninja. And yeah, Scarf Greninja, okay. He didn't Mega Evolve, they're potentially predicting Ice Beam, so this is a free Mew. Oh, he goes Garchomp, okay. I thought Mew was the play there, but like, maybe I'm... It depends on the Mew set, I guess. He knew it didn't Mega Evolve, so Garchomp was fine too, yeah. I thought the Garchomp or the, yeah, Garchomp or Greninja has to be Scarf. But yeah, on Psychic Mewtwo's team, it has to be Scarf Greninja to check Volcarona. Also, like, even though Pinsir can check Volcarona, Quick Attack does a good chunk to Volk, but you don't Oko it, and... Like... Rocks can be on your side, your pins is not always healthy, so it's not the most reliable check. But he doubles out, predicting the Rock Slide from the Rock Slide from the Garchomp or something like that, or the Dragon Claw. So Landorus was a fine switch. I assume it's Z-Move, Tapu Bulu on both teams, actually. I mean, it's kind of cool that they, in the sense that I don't have to analyze that much, because they have like the same mons and everything. Oh yeah, I hope the audio is fine, by the way, because... Well, the audio might be a bit too low. But yeah, this is defensive Rocks Landorus. He obviously wasn't staying in with his Magnezone there. Not worth risking his Greninja check. It can also probably live a CC from the range it's at. So yeah. Mew got a free Will-O-Wisp there. I maybe would have gone into my own view. To my own Mew to like at least get the burn on this too. But he could have also gone for default, because I think this is default Mew. Yeah, you have a Pinsir, this has to be default Mew. And just in general, like spikes are annoying. And he stays in on the Battle Bond Greninja and gets flinched, so that sucks a lot. But I mean, he didn't have good switch ins in the first place, so he would have either gone for default or Volt Switch, something like that. Not really sure what he predicted there, but yeah, he didn't really have good switch-ins. I probably would have gone to Greninja there. But even then, like... Okay, as a team, we regret nothing. Yeah, that's interesting. But yeah, this is like the only game after the easy game that I was able to catch for this week of OUPL, which is week 4. So he decides to save his Mew, which dies to Rocks. But yeah, this is an extra fodder for him, I guess, at least. I can understand that he didn't go hard Bulu, obviously, because he doesn't know which Greninja it is. And he could also potentially have predicted the Ice Beam from the Greninja. But like, if I was him, I would have either gone Magnezone or hard Greninja. Because like, he's Scarf Greninja with U-turn probably, so he can just... see what this goes for, and you can U-turn out into the like appropriate, like into Magnezone. He could have U-turned after going Greninja. Like Dark Pulse would have done like with Rocks a bit over half to the Greninja, I think. But yeah, this is like potentially he's gonna predict the Magnezone here and go for HP Fire, but I think Flash Cannon should be okay. He can even go for Volt Switch. He can go for Volt Switch too. We see the Tapu Bulu is faster actually, so this could be Z superpower Tapu Bulu. So there's the potential that Psychic Mewtwo wants to switch out on a potential Z superpower into Landorus here, but he doesn't, okay. Okay, I thought he would scout for a Z move. That's interesting. Like, Bulu got the grassy terrain first, so I think it's faster. It should work that way. But yeah, Garchomp, if it has Toxic, it can go for Toxic breaking the Landorus. Earthquake might not even kill in grassy terrain. It should still kill. I'm not 100% sure, but it should still kill, yeah. But like, you have a free Landorus switch, and so I double the Greninja here. But he can't really do much. Like, okay, Scarf Rocks probably. Wait, did I just say he's Scarf Rocks? He's Scarf Greninja. Yeah, this Garchomp is not Scarf. What am I saying? Yeah, I'm sorry. It's 2 a.m. here. I just had some things in my head that I wanted to say, because I recorded with Dennis the Menace, and I just realized that the recording after a few minutes, my OBS fucked up. This is why I changed back now. I'm on a different recording program now, because I finally get my OBS to work with 1080 HDP stuff. But yeah, I had some trouble with it. Like, it's lagging sometimes. My computer's not that good. But yeah, it's gonna go for Yuuzhan here with his Scarf Greninja, obviously. As we see, Sakimichi is running Surf on his Ashgren, on his Battle Bond Greninja. He doesn't want to miss. I saw that Garchomp. It could have been Z-move Garchomp, now that I think about it. Goes to Landorus, predicting Yuuzhan to get some helmet damage, which is a cool play. But yeah, like, the Garchomp might just be SD Z-move. Or Rock 3 attacks with Z-move. With, like, Earthquake, Dragon Claw, Fire Blast, something like that. And then, like, Z-move or Z-Fire Fang. But probably it's SD 2 attacks with Devastating Drag, something like that. Because he didn't go for the Z-superpower with his Bulu. Unless he's Z-Stonage on the Bulu, I don't know why you wouldn't go for Z-superpower on the Magnezone earlier. That's weird. But yeah, he can go and tap a Bulu here. I don't really see what else you would do besides going tap a Bulu. Because if you go Pinsir, you take Rocks. And this also, Pinsir also can't kill Landorus. And then you take Helmet and stuff, so yeah, Bulu's the play. But yeah, I think Sakimichi just wins this game, because he, like, it's kind of even matchup, but he got that flinch on the Mewtwo, or he got the Greninja in on the Mewtwo, which was pretty crucial. How did he get it in again? So I assume we're gonna see, this has to attack here, because the Landorus can just go for a slow U-turn. I assume this outspeeds the Landorus, because most Landorus don't run that much speed on defensive. So yeah, this outspeeds, because there's no point in SDing. Like, if you SD, he just U-turns out. And then he brings in, like, the pins since the revenge is used, so that, or, like, something like Ice Beam Greninja, or something like Magnezone, if this is not Z-superpower. So, like, he still has options to revenge this. So, like, yeah, Honglish was the best play, just getting damage on the Landorus. Yeah, I'm not really sure how close I can go to my mic, because this is the struggle when you switch between recording programs. The one program picks up the voice, like, way louder than the other one. And I'm used to being a bit more far away from my mic on OBS, but here I have to be more close, otherwise it fucks up my voice. Like, my voice is like super low if I don't get go close to this one. But yeah, he went. True Magnezone sent out Mew. Oh yeah, he brought the Greninja and the Will-O-Wisp. Yeah, okay, I remember now. Yeah, Psychic Mew do. Yeah, Mew's gotten more common this metagame. Like, he had a free Will-O-Wisp there as his opponent had earlier. So he's probably gonna go for slow Volt Switch with Magnezone. I don't think he would go Landorus here. So he's knockoff Mew, which is interesting. I think he has to be Defog and Softballed in the last two slots, which means he doesn't have Psychic. Like, if he's not Defog, that's just super weird with the pins there. But yeah, he can go into his Greninja or into his, if he has Toxic, Garchomp. Because, like, Mew should take a hit from Pinsir. It gets leftovers and grassy terrain back after this turn, so it's gonna be pretty healthy. And Pinsir can, like, Pinsir would get Will-O-Wisp basically, unless it's substitute Pinsir. It was substitute Pinsir, that would have actually been a threat, kinda. But yeah, I think Finch played earlier versus J-State, and they either played on main or just missed the game. I don't know. Wait, there's someone saying, is that game won? Or there's Solvent playing versus Sugar High? Not sure what that's for. But he decides to go hard in Tabu Bulldogs. We see Protein Dark Pulse Greninja. That's not a set that's common at all. Especially after the Metagross ban. You don't really see Dark Pulse. It's only for Spadef Jirachi, I think. Because some people use Spadef Jirachi to check Protein Greninja, because HP Fire doesn't do that much. As we see Substitute Bulldogs. Yeah, this looks like something that League used. I was saying that earlier. But then I realized, didn't talk more about that, because I was like trying to figure out if they had the exact same team, and then I realized he had one more different. But yeah, this Z move, probably Z super power, and yeah, blows the Magnezone away. But yeah, this Pinsir can break the substitute, but I assume this last move is gonna be the SD and Horn Leech. So the Bulu cannot do much to this. So technically this Pinsir can even go for SD. And it can kinda even, this Pinsir can even kinda win the game. I mean, I get that you wanna break the substitute first. But now that you see this can't do anything for you, you can SD up here. He's probably gonna sack his Landorus here. You can SD on the Landorus switch and you can kill every return. / frustration. Yeah, return. And that's actually pretty cool for him. But he doesn't decide to make that play. Maybe Water Shuriken from Greninja does. Yeah, he has Water Shuriken from Greninja. And maybe he doesn't have a move to hit the Magnezone, not sure. I think he could have won with his Pinsir. But yeah, he would have taken Helmet, so he would have been at 40 something, and then he had Specs. So he I don't know why he went Garchomp there exactly, what he predicted exactly. Probably that the Magnezone doesn't have a move to hit that, I don't know. That was weird. So the substitute doesn't break, so this is probably HP invested Bulu, or maybe it's just that bulky naturally, but I assume it has some HP. Bulu is kind of underwhelming bulky wise, on the bulky side, at least if you use the offensive set. The super dev at least is pretty bad, the defense is okay, the fist dev. But yeah, this SD doesn't really do anything. Yeah, this makes me think he's maybe Stone Age? Because otherwise he could have gone for the Z superpower to kill this. But yeah, he's just gonna pick up the Bulu here. I kinda forgot. I wanted to say something else, but I forgot what. I was at some turn where I forgot to say something. Yeah, I was talking about him potentially winning with Pinsir. So it would have been Oh, that crit might have mattered. But yeah. I think. Oh, he said that didn't matter. Greninja wins. Yeah, at this point it doesn't matter, obviously, for the deciding of the game. But he wins a potential speeder, yeah, or probably a speeder. So, I think his only way of winning was when he had the Pinsir in on the Bulu. I think he had to SD. Yes, you take Rocky Helmet, which brings you to I think he would have been at 48%, something between 46 and 49%. So he pretty much killed everything. He just had to win a speed type versus the Psychic Mewtwo's Pinsir. Yeah, he still had to win a speed type versus Psychic Mewtwo Pinsir. And also Mew might have, if it's Fist Dev Mew, it might have lived the frustration. We're gonna calc that real quick. So Mew utility, but this Mew is for Dev, so I'm gonna calc Let's put 256 bold. I know they run. They don't run. Why am I fucking stuttering, dude? Why can I not talk today? So, I say that sometimes pretty often. So I don't know why, but yeah, Mew does not run this much bulk. But I just want to figure out if we have a Pinsir here at +1, a Mega Pinsir at +1 because he had the Intimidate that he gets up with the Landorus. It does 63 of 75. And the Mew would have been at 72. So it would have been a roll in Psychic Mewtwo's favor. But Mew doesn't run that much defense. Let's say the standard spread, I think it's 56, something like that. Then it does, then it guarantees kills 72 to 85. Because it was at 72 or 71 after rocks, I think. And I don't know if the spread was bold, but I've seen a lot of 56 defense Mews that I've used on teams that I got from people. Like, I know that Mew runs sometimes mixed defensive, because it's like, that way you can potentially, you eat up Gunkshot from Greninja and you eat up Ice Beam and Hydro Pump from Greninja. So it's basically a defog that I can defog on Protein Greninja, which is like the only, like, Protein Greninja beats most defoggers, which is what makes it so good. It has access to spikes and it beats the defoggers. It beats Feeny with Gunkshot, Latios with Ice Beam, and who else is a defogger? Zapdos dies to Ice Beam. And Mule is like the only one that can check it, which is like the only reason you would run Dark Pulse, I guess. Like, some of the two had Dark Pulse, I don't remember who, I think it was this guy. I don't want to butcher your name, so I'm not going to try to pronounce it. Yeah, I guess the hex sucked. It definitely wouldn't have been a 6-0. Wouldn't have been a 6-0, I think. Which hex, what is it again? I can't remember. But yeah, what I'm trying to say is, at the end of the game, his only way was like to win with the pincer at the point he was at. So I don't, I think he should have gone for it. Because that was his opportunity to get up an SD. So if he would have gotten up that SD, killed the Landorus with the plus one frustration, then he potentially had to get a roll on the Mew, depending on the Mew's EV spread, and Greninja had to get like low water shuriken hits if he wins the speed tail with Pinsir. So he still has to win the speed tail with Pinsir, potentially get a roll on the Mew, and yeah, this is kind of weird. I'm looking at Psychic Mewtwo's team, I'm just trying to realize, like, he's still like, Greninja should not do that much to a Mega Pinsir. Like, it's not in his Ash form yet. I'm gonna put regular Greninja. I just want to make the colors to, like, see how much. So the Pinsir would have been at like 49, something along those lines. And yeah, we have a choice specs here. And yeah, I might be wrong here, but I'm like trying to figure out. So yeah, what does Shuriken does? 37 to 46, so it wouldn't have killed if it gets 3 hits. Because the Pinsir was at, I think, at 47 to 49, something along those lines. I don't think it would have killed if he got 3 hits. Which means that he could have won if he won the quick attack speed tag with this Pinsir. But maybe it was Adamant Pinsir, not sure. And also, there was another point that I wanted to talk about, but I forgot. Yeah, okay, yeah, I'm looking at his team and I'm like, what is the way of checking Volcarona? Because he doesn't have a Scarfer. So I guess he could have been... I don't know if it was confirmed if he was AV on his Magnezone. Like, someone knocked off... I think his AV Magnezone got knocked off, but I don't think this got... But it has to be AV looking at the team still. Just because, like, Ash Greninja is, like, scary as fuck to this team. Like, you resist as your own Ash Greninja, and like Tapu Bulu is not a Tapu Bulu resisted, but it still does like so much with Hydro Pump. Even with Dark Pulse, it does a good chunk, like, if it gets off the Ash. But yeah, I don't know how he beats Volcarona. His way Volcarona is getting up rocks and then quick attack to check it with Pinsir. And Greninja has Water Shuriken. Yeah, that's his way to check Volc priority, basically. Mew can potentially take a hit, but Mew probably can't do much back. Because he showed knockoff Will-O-Wisp, so he has to be defog Roost then, I think, yeah. But yeah, I don't know why I'm rambling so long. This might be wrong, but like, let me know what you guys think about this, if he could have won if he went for SD with his Pinsir. Thank you for watching, and I hope the sound is audible for you, and like, I hope it's fine. Like, it sucks a lot that my video with Dennis got messed up. Like, it's fine for like 12 minutes, and after that, like, the screening got like laggy. I don't know the exact number of minutes where it starts lagging. Yeah, I was using OBS and I was like uploading the video, and I just realized after a few minutes it was up. Like, someone made a comment about it, but I realized it just like 2 minutes before he made the comment. Well, that sucks. But yeah, this game I could kind of give an okay analysis, but like a few turns I was like, eh. I just saw this game started, so I'm like used to using OBS now, so I it was like weird for me to click on the other recording program and like open it really fast and stuff, because like it takes like 30 or 40 seconds to open, because this computer is pretty slow. And I forgot what I wanted to say. This computer is pretty slow. What else? Yeah, basically I had to set everything. I put the open the program, open the music, and because I wanted to get at least some OUPL for you guys, because I haven't gotten any this weekend. And yeah, I missed the finished game because I couldn't catch that live. I missed X-Ray vs. Sabella because I came like a few minutes too late. Like they played 1 p.m. my time, like early. What else did I miss? Yeah, Black and White I don't really record. I missed Empo versus Subject 18. Like Empo hexed a bit, not a bit, he hexed a lot. And yeah, I missed the Evangelist game, like I see, you guys can see. And I also missed League vs. DJ. Okay, Darius the God. Yeah, I missed a lot of games. So what do we have here? I also missed Gypsy King, which sucks, man. I wanted to catch that game live. Yeah, they played yesterday at like 2 a.m. my time. Like I went to bed at like 11 p.m. So I missed that. But yeah, I have ADF test with Latna. It's tomorrow. I hope I can catch that. Top 2 Boys should be playing tomorrow. And yeah, they already played. I think Lighthouse still plays with Kroven, if I'm not mistaken. And then it's gonna be only be like Gondra vs. Ricardo that I'm hyped for, and then Femi vs. Pearl, Scan vs. Roses. I don't know who Scan is. No idea, dude. Like, I don't know some of these people. Henry vs. Chill Shadow, I don't think they played either. So yeah, I probably don't preview that much this weekend, but I try to figure out the standings for like the last upload that I make, or like if I don't forget it, or I'll bring you the standings in like a separate video or something. I think OUPL only has 6 weeks, and then it's playoffs, but I'm not really sure. It's 6 teams, right? So every team plays each other, basically. So they play them. Maybe it's 5 weeks, actually. I'm super confused how many weeks it is. I'm just mixing things up. But I hope you guys still enjoyed. I don't know why I'm rambling still. Thank you for watching. And yeah, I'll try to work on this, that we will not have any issues in the future again. With the sound, or with the graphic thing, with the video that is lagging like it was with OBS earlier. So I'm probably not gonna use OBS again. This computer can't handle it, man. I'll just have to figure out how my voice doesn't mess up with this program, because this program in general is perfect. But my voice just messes up sometimes. Like if I've recorded other people, their voice gets recorded way louder than mine, and even if I try to put me higher in my program, it doesn't do that. Like, what the fuck, dude? Yeah, peace out, friends. I don't know what's going on here. Like, I'm annoyed, I'm mad. Goodbye.